Welcome to TechCos channel. Today's video, we will see what is ELISA test. This is for the tech by YourTech. ELISA stands for Enzyme-Linked Immunosorbent Assay Rapid Immunochemical Test. It involves an enzyme-substrate biochemical reaction and an antigen-antibody reaction. Before ELISA method, radioimmunoassay was used because this can detect a nanogram or microgram levels. But the radiation was not safe. Engvall and Perlman described in 1971 about ELISA. It's a type of enzyme immunoassay used in quantitative and qualitative methods to detect specific target in the sample. ELISA used as diagnostic tool for medicine, plant pathology, quality control industries such as food industry. Samples. What are the samples we can use for ELISA method? The samples routinely we use serum, plasma, cell culture supernatants, cell lysate, saliva, tissue lysate, urine, or conditioned media. What are the advantages of using ELISA method? Compared to radioimmunoassay, ELISA methods are highly sensitive and specific, and no isotope usage and no expensive radiation counters. Highly sensitive because it comes from enzyme as reporting group. The enzyme is an organic catalyst. A small amount can induce large span of catalytic reaction to produce observable chromogenic reaction as amplification. So a trace of antigen or antibody present subcellular level quantifications can be done in microgram or even nanogram level. Strong specificity, as it uses an antigen antibody selectively, the epitope and paratope level, it shows very strong specificity. Now we'll see what are the reagents we use for ELISA method. Capture antibody or coating antibody. The antibody bound to the 96 well plates are called capture antibodies or coating antibody. Each kit will have specific antibody for antigen detection. The antigen from the sample attached to the antibody in the 96 well plate or the antibody from the sample attached to the antigen in the 96 well plate. The antigen or antibody attached from the sample, it forms an antigen-antibody complex and it becomes immobilized, unconjugated detection antibody. These antibodies are attached to the immobilized antigen-antibody complex. These are specific to the antigen and attached to the epitope, it forms antibody-antigen-again-antibody complex. What are conjugated antibodies? These are enzyme-attached antibodies attached to the antigen-antibody complex in the sandwich ELISA, conjugated antibodies attached to the detection antibodies usually. Conjugated antigens. In competitive ELISA, the antigens are attached with enzymes having similar epitope as sample that can be attached to the immobilized antibodies. 220, the WAS solution. It's a polysorbate type of non-ionic surfactant. Non-specifically bound proteins are washed out by low concentration of TEEN-20 casein WAS solution, and TEEN-20 blocks the antibody free site to prevent false positive attachment. Stop solution, 0.16 molar sulfuric acid. Horseradish peroxidase react with tetramethylbenzidine to produce a blue byproduct having maximum absorbance of 605 nanometer. The color intensity is directly proportional to the amount of HRC activity that is related to the amount of analyte present in the sample. Addition of 0.16 molar sulfuric acid stop solution changes the color to yellow, and its stabilized yellow color is read at 450 nanometer using a spectrophotometer or plate reader. For alkaline phosphatase enzyme, 0.5 molar sodium hydroxide is used. Types of ELISA. Direct ELISA. An antigen from the sample is immobilized directly onto the plate and a conjugated detection antibody binds to the target antigen. Substrate is then added, producing a signal that is proportional to the amount of analyte. Advantages are it's very fast, it's a single step, simple method. Disadvantages, it is less specific because only one antibody is used. High background may be seen when all proteins are immobilized in well. Other method is indirect ELISA. The antibody is fixed to the 96 well plate. The antigen from the sample is attached to these antibodies and becomes immobilized. An unconjugated primary detection antibody is added that binds to the specific antigen. A conjugated secondary antibody directed against the host species of the primary antibody is added. Then adding substrate produces a signal proportional to the amount of antigen in the sample. Advantages: amplification using a secondary antibody becomes very highly amplified and specific. Disadvantage: potential for cross-reactivity caused by secondary antibody. Next, sandwich ELISA. The most common type of ELISA used, two antibodies are used to sandwich the antigen. Capture antibody is coated on a microplate. Protein of interest from the sample binds and immobilized on the plate. Incubation makes the antigen antibody complex. Next, washing removes excess unbound antibodies and leaving only antigen antibody complex. A conjugated detection antibody is added that binds to the additional epitope of the antigen during incubation. Washing removes excess antibodies, leaving only capture antibody, antigen from sample, and conjugated antibody complex. Substrate is added to react with enzyme, a color change that is proportional to the analyte in the sample. Stop solution changes the color and stabilizes the reaction by pH change. The intensity is red. Advantages: highest specificity and sensitivity, since two antibodies are required to bind to analyte of the interest, compatible with complex sample matrix. Disadvantages: it's a long protocol. There's a chance of error in every step. Competitive ELISA. A capture antibody is coated on microplate. The antigen from the sample is allowed to attach to the antibodies. Then washing removes excess antigen, adding conjugated antigen attached to the unbound capture antibodies that competes with antigen from the sample. The more antigen present in the sample, that the less conjugated antigen will bind to the capture antibody. Washing removes extra proteins, allowing only capturing antibody and antigen complex and capturing antibody and conjugated antigen complex. Next, substrate is added that react with enzyme, and the signal produced is inversely proportional to the amount of antigen present in the sample. Here, more color is produced in negative samples. Advantages: ability to quantitate even small molecules. Disadvantages: less specific using only one antibody, requires a conjugated antigen. The newer ELISA methods. Multiplex immunoassay can detect and quantitation to many analyte from a very little sample. It uses flow cytometry that reads at different wavelength, finding different analytes in the same plate. The reverse ELISA method also coming up in research area that will be soon coming to the diagnosis, which can give different reports from a same single test. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, share, and like. Write your comments.